First tonight, jury selection begins in the case against Casey Anthony. Good evening. I'm Jim Payne.
I'm Martha Sagowski. WESH 2 is first to tell you jury selection was going to be in Pinellas County this morning.
All the players are here deciding who will sit on the jury in the trial against the young mother accused of murdering her daughter.
WESH 2's Kara Moore with analysis of today's events.
But we begin with WESH 2's Bob Keeling live tonight in Clearwater. And Bob, you've been in the courtroom all day. Does it look like a jury will be picked there, or could it come back to Orange County?
Well, Jim, one of the very interesting notes early on was Judge Perry even asked Casey Anthony if there was any plea negotiation that she might be a part of right now, and Anthony told him no. As for the jurors, 31 of the first 50 people questioned were excused for hardships, mostly financial. 936 days after her indictment for murder, jury selection for Casey Anthony's murder trial is underway in Clearwater. Court administrators made the location official just after 6 a.m. 110 members of the Pinellas County jury pool filed into the courthouse.
In calling you here today for jury duty, we are mindful of the enormous inconvenience we will be imposing.
The 12 jurors and 8 alternates chosen will be taken to Orlando and sequestered for 6 to 8 weeks. They're not to watch news, read the papers, or surf the net.
Including tweeting, texting, blogging, email.
The defense moved quickly to strike this jury pool for lack of minorities.
It should be representative of the population of Orange County, and which I don't think that this panel does.
Your request to strike the panel will be denied.
Early on, Casey Anthony sat facing members of the jury pool, looking away, wiping away tears. Perry told the audience not to consider emotion.
Purchased that dress?
Yes, I have.
Perry excused dozens for financial hardships and one man who said his mind is made up.
She's guilty.
Yes, sir.
Now, there is one other important note. Early on today, Judge Perry issued a ruling where he will allow those positive sniff tests for decomposition in Casey Anthony's car. It was the subject of more argument late this afternoon, and we're expecting it to be brought up again tomorrow, so that issue's not over. Reporting live in Pinellas County, I'm Bob Keeling, WESH 2 News.
Casey Anthony had to take a new mugshot photo when she was brought into Pinellas County. WESH 2 News has obtained the video of Casey being brought in and booked into the Pinellas County Jail. She was placed up against a counter and searched before being checked in. And then she had her mugshot taken so she could be registered as an inmate in the jail. This mugshot joins the host of other mugshots taken of Casey during her time behind bars. So why Pinellas County? Well, jury selection isn't so much about comparable age, gender, or race anymore. WESH 2 experts say there are a lot more factors that come into play. Pinellas County is located on the Gulf side with a population of about 1 million people. It's also a different TV market than Orlando, so the Casey Anthony case doesn't get as much airtime as it does here. There are more retired people there, and that increases the chances that a potential juror would have the time and financial means to take time off for a 2-month trial. Also, experts say viewers in Pinellas County are used to big crime cases, a lot more so than one of Florida's more rural counties.
Of course, once the jury is picked, there is the matter of keeping them locked down. Sequestering a jury on a trial with this kind of media attention is no easy task. All new tonight, WESH 2's Kara Moore with what our expert says is required to get Casey a fair trial.
No TV, no newspapers, no surfing the net. Those are just some of the rules Casey Anthony's jury will have to follow. Sequestering a jury for such a high-profile capital murder trial will be no easy task.
I think you're going to see one of the most professional security systems that we've ever had in Florida working on this case.
WESH 2 legal analyst Judge O.H. Eaton says jurors will be guarded 24 hours a day. Their every move will pretty much be watched. Phone calls to family members may be allowed if monitored by deputies.
Well, that's why it costs so much money. When the jurors are in court, they are being, of course, taken care of by armed deputies. When they leave the courthouse, they leave in a police van. They're taken to a motel. They are watched over by the deputies. Their television access is limited. Their access to other people is limited.
The cost for the jury's isolation will add up. Meals, transportation, even laundry service will all have to be covered.
And this afternoon, Judge Perry said he may allow jurors weekend visits with family, but has not set any guidelines for that yet. Live in the newsroom, Kara Moore, WESH 2 News.